First on Cross Country Today, we'll go to Charlottetown. Mr. Dress-Up brought children's television to life on the Confederation Center stage there.
But for right now, do you want to see a trick or two? Okay, here we go.
Mr. Dress-Up, a legend in his time, was on Prince Edward Island this week as part of an Atlantic Provinces tour. Even after 22 years, the popularity of the Mr. Dress-Up show is undiminished.
Any skeletons?
Is the man behind the character of Mr. Dress-Up a distinct and separate personality?
Actually, when I started doing Mr. Dress-Up, I didn't see him as a character, an overt character that I had to, where I had to put on a different voice or a lot of makeup or a funny beard or something like that. So he was basically me with a different name doing things that I do like to do. And I think that's been a saving grace over the years because I haven't had to keep up a certain facade on television. And I was telling somebody the other day, they asked the same question or similar one, and I said, well, I think probably having been Mr. Dress-Up for 20 years has probably made me a better person than I might have been if I just kept on just being a regular actor or whatever, because I have to absorb a lot of the, I don't know, the niceness, the thoughtfulness that Mr. Dress-Up has. And so I think Mr. Dress-Up's been a good influence on me.
It's quite astounding to consider the influence that Ernie Coombs has had on generations of Canadian children. And judging from his performance at the Confederation Center, Mr. Dress-Up is by no means ready to pack up his old tickle trunk and leave us. I'm Deirdre Kessler in Charlottetown.